Hey everybody, happy Wednesday. It is I, your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe Sebi. And happy Wednesday, guys. And Wednesday is part of our creative writing class that we like to call ghostwriting. Ghostwriting is when we take a popular song, and we take the chorus, and only the chorus, not the verse, not the pre-chorus, just the chorus, and we have to rewrite our own original lyrics and replace our own original lyrics with the lyrics that are already in the chorus. Okay. This is not an easy exercise. Maybe it can be sometimes, but other times can be really hard, depending upon what song you pick, how wordy it is, how many words are in it, how long the chorus is, every other line rhymes, you're trying to do that as well. And the reason I do this, one of the reasons I do this, or we do this as a class, and the exercise is because, A, it just keeps your chops up. It's not an easy exercise. It's not easy to do at all. It makes you really have to sit down and read their chorus, first of all. Look at how they wrote it. Look how many lines it takes to actually go from the beginning of the chorus to the end. Read how many syllables are in each word. And here's the thing. There's really no rules with this except your words got to rhyme, of course. You can't use any of their lines. And it's got to make sense. Your song's got to tell a story. Okay? And it's always like, the object, I always say this, even though it sounds cocky, I'm not trying to be cocky. The object is to write a better chorus than they wrote. I know it's, can it be the same subject matter? Of course, just as long as it ain't the same lyrics. I mean, it could be the same sentiment. It could be a love song if it's a love song. Yeah. You can write whatever you want to write it about. Like I said, as long as it makes sense and it tells a story, okay? Now, I'm going to show you an example of this just so you're understanding. I say this a lot, but I'm going to repeat myself because it's very good to just hear this over and over. If you're doing a song and the song has a four-syllable word in the line, try to write a four-syllable word in your line. It doesn't have to be like that. You could have four one-syllable words if they're stacked together the right way that match up with your four-syllable word, then we're fine. Do you know what I mean? And a good way to do this, and I do this all the time, is I write, I take a piece of, I take my paper like this, right? I take my paper. See, here's lyrics, right? So I wrote theirs, there's their line, and then I wrote mine, and I write mine right under it. And if they have a one-syllable word, I have a one-syllable word. If they have a two-syllable word, I try to use a two-syllable word. Now, I have used like four one-syllable words in place of a four-syllable single word. You know what I mean? Like I said, it doesn't matter. As long as yours makes sense, tells a story, and has a cool hook, and it's the same melody, you should be able to sing this right along with the singer, and your words should fit perfectly. When they start a word, you start a word. When they end a word, you should end a word. It should be perfectly aligned with their line. Does that make sense to you? Yeah. And like I said, oh my God, this takes hours sometimes. It takes me hours sometimes to do this, and it's not easy. Sometimes I rewrite things because I just didn't like where I went with it. I just painted myself into a corner, and now I can't get out. So like, I changed, like, you know, I've done it where I have to just redo it. But this is another good reason why we do this, is I call this first verse curse, okay? You're writing a new song and you put all your best work into your first verse and your chorus. So like, when you get to verse 2, you're like, where do I go now, right? Well, like verses are chapters, like in a book, right? Chapter 2 is going to be different than chapter 1, right? It can't be like, you know, the Titanic chapter 1 isn't the boat sinking. No, they're on a cruise. People are meeting each other. They're having fun. You know, by chapter 7 or 8 is when the, you know, the boat hits the iceberg and, you know. So every, you know, everything's a story, you know, like Monday morning is a story. Tuesday morning is a story. Tuesday morning is chapter 2. Wednesday is chapter 3. And so on. It's like, so songs should be similar to that. Like, a, you know, a core or a verse is your chapter. And what always stays the same is the chorus, right? That's what makes the song singable. Everyone sings along because they remember every time after the verse and the pre-chorus comes the hook, the big hook. And that's where we all sing along, okay? So this is really good to just exercise your mind to be able to be flexible enough to look at something and at a certain time come out with something that's as good. And, you know, these are all just great exercises to get your chops up, you know. So the song that we're doing tonight, listened to a bunch of stuff on Billboard tonight, and I heard a song by a girl named Sabrina Carpenter. And the song is called Skin. And I thought it was a really nice song. I love her voice. She's a newer artist. I love her other song that she has. Driver's License, I think it's called. I love that song. And I love this one too. It's a great song. So when you listen to this, like I said, I want you to really listen to the chorus, okay? The chorus comes in at about 38 seconds or so. So that'll let you know. Look at the timer on your timeline on your YouTube. So again, her name is Sabrina Carpenter. The song is called Skin. And I'm going to play you the chorus. Oh, you can try to get on the mind, on the mind, on the mind skin while he's on mine. Yeah, on the mind, on the mind. So I'm going to read you her words, okay? So I know you saw them on the screen, but I'm just going to repeat them, okay? Okay, so you can try to get under my skin, okay? While he's on mine, yeah, all on my skin. And you can try... Yeah, so wait, let me go back to, yeah, here it is. So here we go. It's, here it comes. Sorry, here we go. You can try to get under my skin while he's on mine. Yeah, all on my skin. I wish you knew that even you can't get under my skin if I don't let you in. Okay? So that's the whole chorus. So what I wrote was, just one kiss and I'm falling and fall. Yeah, just one kiss and I'm falling in love and I'm in bliss. You're calling me love, lost in your eyes, blue as the skies. I keep falling in love. You're the one I think of. So that's my words. And like I said, it's really good if you put them right under each other. You see that? There's mine. You see? I put mine directly under theirs. And then I can compare it. And it's really easy to see. And the other thing that's really tough about this is you got to say, if the chorus is short, you got to say something that's universally understood, which means it's like everyone can understand exactly what you're trying to say in the chorus. It should be universal. It shouldn't be like a private joke. You know what I mean? Inside joke or something. or just an inside thing between two friends. It should be something that everybody listens from the first time they understand exactly what you're saying in the song. So now I'm going to give you a little example of me just doing mine as a little demo. So here we go. So here goes. Coming up. Just one kiss and I'm falling, falling, falling in love and I'm in bliss. You're calling, you're calling, you're calling me love. Lost in your eyes, blue as the skies. I keep falling in love. You're the one I think of. That's it. That's the whole thing. I sang it an octave lower, of course, because my voice is a little shot. But anyway, guys, that is all the time we have for tonight. This is your songwriting partner, your co-producer, and as always, your friend Joe Seabee signing off. I will see you guys tomorrow on our Picture This Creative Writing class. Until then, I love you. I miss you. Be safe, and I will see you tomorrow. Peace.